Hiya. So I want to talk a little bit more about Trump. And I mentioned the Bolton book that came out recently in an earlier podcast. And I won't go more into what he said here, but except for one thing, which is what I want to talk about today. So Bolton said that two terms of a Trump presidency would be a disaster, but one term we can recover from. And I agree. So I will say that Trump has done definite damage to our democracy, to our republic, to our economy, but more importantly, to our sense of who we are and our institutions, our norms, and our ability to function as, you know, together as Americans. However, because he has done this, he has also exposed problems that already existed. And in some ways, one might argue that if someone had planned, and I'm not saying Trump did this, but if someone had planned to expose all of these problems and do so in the least damaging way that still woke us up and made us rethink things and reform and make sure that this doesn't happen again and in a worse way, maybe Trump has fulfilled on that. Maybe this is exactly what someone would plan. A minimum of deaths caused by this, but still a wake-up call that will actually be effective. And so I'll explain what I mean, right? So if someone wanted to do that, they would plan to expose weaknesses, including areas where things are not codified into law, things are just norms. And so someone evil, like a Hitler, could come in and violate those norms with impunity. And Trump has done that. And now I've got to stop here for a moment and say Trump could be that Hitler type person, right? If he got a second term, he could be that. He has already not only done many, many, many racist dog whistles and outright racist statements. He also cut funding to the FBI's investigation into white supremacist terrorism. He also talked about bloodlines in a really creepy Nazi-like way. And recently he had ads that were pulled by Facebook because they had neo-Nazi symbols in them, Nazi symbols in them, including this upside-down red triangle that was used to label four concentration camps, label sort of leftist dissenters, right? So that they would be murdered in concentration camps. And he included that in his Facebook thing, and it wasn't by accident. And he put out the ad that had that symbol in it 88 times, which is apparently a signal, eight for H and H, eight again for H, so Heil Hitler. And this is like a well-known thing. And whether it was Trump or a lackey of his, whether he signed on full-throated or not, you know, he did this, and it was clearly not an accident. There would be too many coincidences lined up. It was definitely on purpose. And so he could be that Hitler, right? If he got a second term, if he stayed in office, he could absolutely become a horrible authoritarian who, he's already put his own people into place everywhere that he possibly can, right? He's got rid of people who speak out against him every time, and put his own people into place. And that's in the DOJ and in the administration, as well as, you know, if someone speaks out against him in an elected position, he fights against them in whatever way he can for in that scenario as well. So don't underestimate the danger. However, if he remains a one-term president, if we get rid of him and if we learn the lessons, then he will have been, looking back, possibly the wake-up call that we needed with a minimum of deaths. Now, I say a minimum. There certainly have been some. There are white supremacists out there murdering protesters and hanging black people, like in lynchings, from trees, right? So there are definitely murders and deaths as a direct result of Trump's racism and white supremacist ideas and support. So don't get me wrong, I'm not trying to minimize this or give him any credit. However, if we learn from it, if we get rid of him and learn the lessons that he has exposed, then we can perhaps make American democracy, the American Republic, better than ever. Equal rights better than ever. We can recognize, as we are right now with Black Lives Matter, the major problem of police brutality, police racism, systemic racism, and the criminal justice system. You know, we can wake up to that problem, which has existed for a long, long time, right? It sort of took over from Jim Crow laws, and which themselves took over from slavery in terms of continuing an oppression against especially Black people, but also other minorities and other poor people, right? Not to say all Black people are poor, obviously, but it's mostly been perpetrated against poor and minority people, and especially young Black men. But this is a long-term problem, and if we can wake up to it and make a change because of the moment that we're in right now with Donald Trump as president, then something good will have come of it. And we can say the same for the realization of the holes in our democracy and the problems where, you know, we expect a leader to follow norms. And Donald Trump is not afraid to admit a lot of what he's doing, whereas past presidents perhaps did some of these things, violated some norms, but hid it and lied better. So maybe he's exposing more issues that already existed than we might even realize. So another thing that he's exposing is problems that occur when partisanship sort of becomes complicity, where one party or another is willing to go along with literally everything that the president does, because the president is from their party. And we see that with the Republicans and how they have gone along with everything Trump did, including impeachable offenses and let him off the hook and basically defend all of his lies. So he's exposing also what happens when a president is willing to lie in a very clear way. Again, because past presidents have lied, like we got lied into the Iraq War, but it's sort of seen as this occasional thing and not a serious problem. But what if a president is willing to lie all the time? And we're seeing exactly what that can lead to right now. And we're seeing the way that this, the complicity of a president's party and other things like this, and the norms versus laws issue, the way that that can erode the balance of powers. So the way that Republicans went along with Trump shows that the Congress doesn't necessarily keep a check on the president if the Congress is from the same party. Previously, we had noticed that if the Congress was from an opposite party, it could slow down the president and what they're trying to do. But we hadn't quite realized the opposite point of view. When they're the same party and they go along with everything a president does, that can allow a president that is taking advantage of this to go to major extremes and get away with all of it. We've also seen that the runaway executive power and the ability for this to be used by a charismatic leader or a demagogue, how that could be an extremely big problem, where American democracy is opened up to the ability for an authoritarian sort of dictator to take over and to become like a Hitler or a Mussolini or a whoever, or a Putin, right? And Trump has exposed his neo-Nazi, his Nazi-type ties, right? And has shown himself to be a demagogue and to have authoritarian tendencies. And so he's exposed the fact that the American system, like European system, parliamentary system, can be taken over by a demagogue, and you can literally end up with a sort of a Hitler figure, right? And this is something Americans never thought was possible before, but now we're seeing it. And if he gets a second term, we could see the full extent of it, right? So this is a serious, serious danger. But if we stop it now, if we learn now, we can potentially learn the lessons required so that it won't happen again going forward, at least for the next few decades, if we make those repairs to the system, if we learn the necessary lessons. So, I mean, Trump recently had these Facebook ads where he had these literal Nazi symbols. He also, these were the symbols used for dissenters, left-wing dissenters at concentration camps. And we learned from the Bolton book that he supported concentration camps with the, in speaking to the Chinese leader, right? He's also praised Nazi, like, style birth lines, you know, oh, you have great genetics. He cut spending on FBI investigations into white supremacist terrorism and all of his dog whistles and white supremacy. So this is the most dangerous potential Nazi type leader. And we have got to wake up to this. And if we do, we can prevent this kind of thing from happening in the future. But we have to make those reforms. All right, so if he had wanted to reveal these dangers in a way with a minimum of deaths, maybe this is how it would be done. I'm not saying that he did it on purpose, but this might be the kind of thing that someone would have to do to wake Americans up to this danger. And we have got to wake up, and we have got to improve our public conversation. We've got to realize that we don't want lies. We don't want a separation of truth into my truth and your truth. We need to have a shared set of facts, a shared reality. And we need to wake up to this problem. And Trump is exposing this problem with his disinformation every day, his, you know, selective ideas on what truth is that include anything he wants you to believe is true, even if they're all lies. And he distrusts mainstream media, supposedly. He says that they're giving you fake news. And so we have people believing one set of facts and people believing another set of facts, and both of them are arguing that the other one is fake, that the other one is lies. We need to figure out how to get to a place where we have a shared reality, a shared set of facts. And one platform that I'm working on about that, to try to get us to a place where we have a shared set of facts, is called Concordis. You should check it out. But any different kind of platform or tool that can help us find a shared set of facts is super important right now. We need to get to a place where we can be on the same page in our discussions, where we can understand where the other one is coming from. If you want to check out Concordis, it's www.concordis.io. C-O-N-C-O-R-D-I-S, Concordis.io. Check it out. It's a place where people can debate and only facts are used, not propaganda and rhetoric and so forth. Just facts, debating back and forth. So this is what Trump has exposed, and we need to take it seriously. We need to come to a place where we have a shared reality, where we aren't distracted by disinformation and manipulated, and can become more sophisticated in our understanding of our democracy, of our democratic republic, where we can know what should be codified into law and what norms we can count on and what to do when someone violates those norms, as well as what to do when someone lies and spreads disinformation, and how we can get to a place where we can have a shared public conversation with science, fact, and truth, and debate reasonably and with empathy. Something Trump has not shown, empathy for each other, a willingness to understand and empathize with each other when we come from a different place, when people have different experiences with racism, with class, you know, the inequality in society that means that some people will be raised with barely enough to eat and in a difficult situation with their education, their home life, their amount of money, and can I pay the rent this month? You know, what do I do when I'm trying to struggle paycheck to paycheck and then the police pull me over? Or, you know, I get a fine that I can't pay, or I end up in jail, which means I lose my job because of something minor. Maybe they did something wrong, but if a rich person had done the exact same thing, like smoke a joint or whatever, even though it might be against the law in a certain state, you know, a rich person does it and it's fine and nothing happens. A poor person does it and they end up in jail overnight, they lose their job, they can't pay for their rent, they lose their house, their apartment, and, you know, and it spirals out of control. And of course, things like payday lending and stuff often feed into it, and then someone ends up in a bunch of debt, and, you know, the spiral happens different ways, but very predictable ways. that doesn't happen for someone else. And if we can have empathy and understand these things and try to find a way to improve the situation without going overboard into socialism, but, you know, where we can make a few changes that can significantly make it, you know, easier to have a fallback position, to have something to lean on in that situation, or to have increased pay to begin with, which would make things a lot easier. However we find, you know, let's debate it. Let's figure out what is the right way to handle this situation. But we need to first empathize, understand where someone is coming from, and then have a reasonable public conversation based on truth and facts where we can delve into the issue and resolve and come to some kind of policy resolution that we can both agree on, that different sides of the aisle can both agree on, or different sides of the spectrum can both agree on. And we need to hold our legislators accountable. We need to press them to deal with these seriously, these issues seriously, and not just be self-serving. And that is maybe the most fundamental thing that Trump has shown us, is that a politician who is entirely self-serving is a disaster for the country. And that's all I have to say. Thanks for listening.